Hello and good morning. My name is Nile Birch and I am from Morristown High School. I would like to begin by thanking Ms. Boswell for this incredible opportunity. I appreciate all of her support and help in making this possible. I am so proud to be representing my African American and social activism club, Melanin Minds, at the Morristown. Melanin Minds consists of a group of united and ethnically diverse individuals dedicated towards raising awareness within our communities. Encouraging change is exactly what our club is about, and I am honored to speak to everyone today about the issue of gun violence on behalf of our president, Bella Simon. So why should I take such vested interest in this issue? I can understand how it is a constitutional right for people to own guns, but as I've come to realize, there's a lot of gray area in that. Nevertheless, that area should never include questioning public safety. If people choose to own guns, that is their prerogative. But in no way, shape, or form should their interest threaten the lives of anyone or anything else. Yet, the trouble I think we all experience is that the current laws that we have are nowhere strict enough to make people feel at ease. Then again, there's a fine line between feeling at ease and feeling safe. We do not need politicians to acknowledge what happened in the past and recent school shootings. We need them to look at Columbine, Sandy Hook, Marjorie Stoneman Douglas, and countless others as an incentive to want to prevent more shootings from ever happening again. In simpler terms, we need to emphasize that it's okay to recognize what happened in the past as long as we use those events to carve out a pathway towards our future. To truly understand what it feels like to be safe, we must first realize what it is like to live in fear. As an African-American male, living in fear means wearing a hoodie and being scared to walk to the store for some Skittles, or an Arizona ice cream, or buying a Skittles TV. What I'm saying is that having this angst festering inside of me every day is my reality, but it does not have to be yours. School shootings, children in school, a place where students go to learn, make friends, and find themselves as human beings. A place parents can drop their kids and feel safe in knowing that their precious children are protected at all costs. It isn't true. It doesn't exist. And that, my friends, is the sad reality of today. Why we are here. Why we care. We must stand together so that every single one of us can feel safe. You might be wondering, what does he mean by starting to make a difference? How can I, a high school student, have any influence? Let me tell you a brief story to make it clear. I remember being on the playground and looking up at those tall monkey bars towering above the field. They seemed so big and tall, like something incredible. Of course, to any 7-year-old, climbing it seemed a feat worth trying. But no matter how hard I tried, it was still physically impossible for my short arms to reach the highest bar. I tell this story because on this day, March 24th, 2018, our end goal may seem impossible to reach. It may seem so idealistic that we doubt seeing such immense change within the course of our lifetime. However, I'm confident that meeting our goal can become a reality by taking the right steps to get there. I didn't finish my childhood story. As I started to climb the bars, I had multiple encounters of failure and defeat by slipping off the handlebars. Enacting change to the issue of gun violence is no different. We have and will continue to encounter obstacles that will try to prevent us from succeeding. In order to overcome these difficulties, it is imperative that we lobby Congress to change the gun laws to ensure that only those who are able to handle the responsibility of owning a gun can do so. It is also paramount that organizations such as the NRA accept the consequences of prioritizing profit over life. I remain optimistic that we'll be able to do this because despite having fallen multiple times in the wood chips, I persevered and yes, eventually reached the top. The feeling at the top of those monkey bars is one I'll never forget. For a brief moment in time, I felt like the king of the world with nothing to stop me. I made my way down and yes, fell again. But this time, it was worth it. I have no doubt that this movement will feel the same way when we make strides. Amen. the obstacles will never truly go away, but we will enact laws, start protests, and incite conversations that will make these obstacles irrelevant. Yeah. Piece by piece, we will inspire other students to gain the courage to stand up for what they believe in.